Take another look at these dots.
Oh, hells yeah. So we're, let me throw up some rando music while we get ready. We're going live on the stream. What? Oh no, am I disconnected?
I'm here.
No. Sorry, there's a bunch of little links that, I guess got assigned different IP addresses. So a bunch of my music links don't work again.
Gotcha.
All right, here.
Let's get some light in here.
Whoa, what's with the spray paint, man?
What's with your outfit, man?
Why don't we put the curtains back?
No. What is going on up here?
I never know, man.
What?
Yeah, I like that.
Boy's soul. All right. Let's see. Oh, look, it's working. Dad, look.
Oh, looking good, Jason.
Yeah.
How you doing, buddy? Hey, buddy. Good to see you, too, man.
Hang on. Let me swap one over. Actually, you know what? I don't know why I'm bothering to do that. Here we go. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so, dude. All right. If you're watching now, just know that this barely happened, just under the wire. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Air. I guess that's as wide as we can get. I'm going to have to aim it from here.
You do this, like, multiple times a week, right?
Yeah, but...
just checking.
But then we go and shoot scam schools, and then everything gets messed up.
Oh, that's what it is.
You fucker.
I'm getting buzzed.
Catching a buzz.
There are six performers buzzing my nuts off. Of your
any idea? All right. Shit. Oh, good. It wasn't open. Yeah! Sometimes the fates go in your way. Thank you, sir. I was convinced. I knew that I was about to explode my beer all over. Here we go. Hey, we both look good. All right. All right, beautiful people. Tell the entire world... Yeah, sorry. We had a massive catastrophe right before we went live.
We did?
Yeah, a little bit.
Everything was fine down in the kitchen when I was drinking.
Yeah, well, you did very well with that. Hey, Alex, are you able to see the text down at the bottom from the chat room?
I sure am. Okay, just good. A little bit, but yes.
Good. Yeah, that's, it's, you know, it's just the chat room right there, so feel free to respond to any
who's this Yahoo?
Question. Yeah, no, I'll introduce him. Here, this is a ramshackle. Our setup is. Although if you send me video, I could actually get decent video of you. Send me
Do
video on the
that?
On
Do
the
really
laptop. On the laptop.
Let's see.
We got this. We got this.
You don't know
oh hey. Dude,
how's
see,
that? Is that better?
It's on.
It started as a survival.
Oh, here
mechanism,
we go.
But now we compete for money, jobs, love.
Oh, hello there.
Power, and just for the hell of it. whether it's a fortune at the track.
So, hello, beautiful people. Hopefully you have enough audio that you can synchronize up and know what is happening. Turn off that overhead light so you can see. We are watching two episodes of Hacking the System, and we have live on the line. One of my favorite things about doing the show was getting to meet and work with one of the writers on there, Mr. Alex Burns. Alex, how are you, sir?
I'm good, thanks. Thanks, Brian. It's great to see you, man.
Yeah, Alex is live on location working on his next project, but he was cool enough to Skype in and join us. Let me see if I can change this to be a shot with all three of us. So if I move that, undo that, change this to that.
So they can watch this on DiamondClub.tv, right?
Yeah, correct. We should be live on DiamondClub.tv.
This thing is filled with numbers that are potential clues to pick a winning horse. And clues can be hacked. I just got to figure out
what are you working on now,
works.
Alex?
I'm working on a show called Human Resources. It's on Pivot, which is a small new network. And it's about a recycling company in Trenton. It's a pretty good time. I like it a lot. Yeah. It's season two. It's actually what I worked on. I did season one of this right before I came back to LA to do Hacking the System and work with you guys.
Of the hosts between Human Resources and Hacking the System, who was sexier?
One of the most important things to win at life?
Oh, I mean, that's easy. The Hacking the System host. I mean, there's no hosts on the other show, so
that's right. There's only talent on the other show. There we go. Hey, look.
You still win.
I got it done all just in time.
Okay. So,
yes. Real quick side note. So you notice that we have a lot of scenes where I'm wearing a suit. Somebody totally called me out. They're like, hey, man, I really like the show, but is that the first time you've worn a suit? You kept buttoning all the wrong buttons. And I was like, yeah, maybe. What are you, a cop?
whenever Brian showed up in the suit, or whenever we left the condo, it was just like, according to Dr. Amy Cuddy,
a psychologist. Yeah. By the way, this part stuff here, and I forgot who it was that dug it all up on the research, but the power pose stuff is so works so well to adopt that I don't want to say dominant, but that confident pose, that Superman pose, that we have actually started to use it with our daughter. Like, she'll start to get upset and we'll say that power pose, and she'll take a deep breath, and then she'll sigh, and then she'll carefully, you know, explain her argument. It's
really,
yeah, no, it makes it works.
Yeah, I mean, I do remember looking that up. I forget what it was, but there was some sort of like Harvard study or something that they had proven that it actually changes your body chemistry, like the levels of chemicals in your body.
One of the things that we were talking about is about how, you know, we've alluded before about how diligent Nat Geo is when it comes to like double sourcing all the material. Like, it has to have more than, you can't just find some Wikipedia article to claim X, Y, or Z. And I know that, like there had to have been times where it's like you had something halfway there, and they just needed more evidence for us to make it on the show.
Yeah, it was definitely tough, but I mean, you know, you can't complain. I mean, that's one of the things. It's cool to work for National Geographic. There's a lot of different networks out there, and that name means a lot more than a lot of other network
names.
Oh,
dude, I
mean,
you were there. You remember during the crimes and misdemeanors episode? That was your episode, right?
I think that's I think that's on next.
No. I think that was on last week.
That's right.
Yeah. I remember.
Thanks for watching.
It's a long story.
I remember that the moment we said the words National Geographic, we would go from some yahoos on the street with cameras to all of a sudden, like, everyone's like, oh, what are you doing? Can I help?
Yeah.
What can I do?
It definitely helps having that credibility to go along with it, because I've worked on other things that shall remain nameless.
Sure.
That could have used the help, but didn't have it.
Hey, Spice Channel is still legit in my book, Mr. Burns.
You're right. I take it back. I'm sorry.
So we're doing the polygraph thing here.
The lie detector thing right here. It's what's so funny is one of my favorite things about this whole experience is that in the beginning, as we're all sort of feeling it out, a lot of the scripts would have like joke lines written in and stuff. And then near the end, I loved Alex's scripts, because it would have like, the script would consist of the facts that we had to get exactly right. And then it would just say, Brian and Jason banter.
and this saved me a lot of time.
Well, this was one of those where it's like we set up the situation, and Jason, you know, you had kind of you wrote all those other questions, and so I remember you saying like, "Do you like wearing lacy women's underwear?" And it's like the moment he said that, I remember thinking like I was like, "How do I answer this in some way that's not." Going to, you know, it's like I don't want to appear to condemn that practice. I don't want to. I also don't want to open up a door.
Well, Alex came up to me before this and said, "Come up with some insane questions. Just get these across, and then just ask him some crazy shit or whatever. Maybe it'll be on the Blu-ray.
Yeah, maybe.
Maybe we can talk about it at some point. Some of the questions that should not be repeated.
Oh, dude, there was so much stuff. Well, and there was moments where it's like, you know, we would. There were moments we just knew that weren't gonna make it through, but were too much fun. But what I loved were the moments where pieces of them actually did. Like in the first episode, we talked about, you know, that moment when we're outrageously cackling was the best moment of us laughing. But I know that moment came from when I forgot what the joke was, totally off color. Was when I was scaring Mitch, and I went into some sideways thing, and we both busted up laughing.
They used the laughter.
Yeah,
chopped right.
I'm television. Sure it was appropriately filthy.
Again, I cannot overstate. Not gonna lie, this chick gave me like a real look on my face. This real wanted to jump my bones vibe. Like it was that looking into the eyes just a little bit too long. And I'm sure you won't be able to see it here, but it's like in that moment she's staring directly into my eyes and so responsive. It was a little bit off-putting. I got uncomfortable.
You can't blame her though, Brian. I mean, especially since you were doing those power poses right before. Yeah. You're incredibly confident. We all know that chicks love that.
Who wouldn't fall for I'm amazing. Like, that is, that's so sexy.
Okay, this is one of my favorite segments. We totally didn't know going into it how well it was going to work. Like, we read the strategy of the pros and stuff, and then we really did just run up and down Hollywood Boulevard playing rock, paper, scissors. And I remember being terrified, like, what if it doesn't work? What if it doesn't work? And at some point, I became convinced that I had a supernatural gift.
It was pretty incredible. I was nervous about it, too. What's funny is somebody actually brought up that exact same study to me just today in the office. Somebody was trying to tell me about it, and I was like, excuse me, I'm way ahead of you on the rock, paper, scissors strategy. Maybe you can turn to next you tonight at 10 o'clock. You'll see.
To be fair, about once a month, Brian is convinced that he has supernatural abilities.
And then I have to be talked off the rooftop by Murphy. He's like, no, it's happening again, Brushwood.
You can't shoot webbing out of orifices in your wrist.
So it happened right at the beginning of this segment, but somebody didn't want to play, and they walked off, and I was so thrilled this made it through the edit, is where it's like they walk past me and ignore me, and I'm like, I'm a human being.
No, I don't think that made it. Side note, little personal story, that place where on the street where that bit wraps up is a check cashing place that way, way back in the day when I had just moved out to LA, I used to cash checks.
No, so this was all your old stomping grounds then.
Oh yeah, I lived in Hollywood. I still live in Hollywood. I've been in Hollywood for 12 years.
So you're
who drove by your apartment?
Yeah, we were pretty close. I used to manage an apartment like right by there.
Oh, wait, you used to manage an apartment?
Yeah, that seemed like a good idea at the time, you know, free rent, you know, free room. But, God, you pay for it. Maybe not in cash, but you pay for it with your sanity.
Oh, dude, yeah. What's funny is, like, when the first place we bought was a duplex, and we lived in one half, and we rented out the other to Jason Murphy. Jason Murphy was Jason's landlord. And then when we bought a grown-up house, we still kept it, and I've had the same tenant in the duplex for like 12 years now.
Really?
He's the first guy to move in after we left.
Oh, wow.
And I just got a text from him today, like, hacking the system? Wow, you're really killing it. And I was like, yeah, remind me to be really nice to you, and please don't trash my house.
Yeah. Well, he's probably like, oh, well, he's got money to replace this.
Oh, geez, I know, right? He's holding me hostage.
Oh yeah, that big, the big hacking the system money.
Yeah. We're gonna have a Scrooge McDuck segment right after the show, where Brian and I are just like, yeah. Swimming in gold.
So one
there
of
is
the
a hack for that.
so one of the things that I mean, obviously Jason and I being you know on the faces of the show, you know, we get people kind of crawling out of the woodwork. We're like, did I see you on TV or whatever? Like, do you tell people? Do most of your friends know what you're working on? Do you get feedback from a lot of your projects?
His parents think he's a librarian.
Yeah. It's funny. Like, most of my friends obviously live in Los Angeles, and a lot of them work in the entertainment, and none of them care at all.
Like, oh, none of them are impressed.
But my friends back home, they care. They care. It's kind of fun. It's exciting. And people have been responding well to it. I mean, I know my dad likes the show, and, I mean, that's pretty high praise, frankly, because he doesn't like much.
I guess that's the funny part is I expect, or what I was terrified of, and I certainly didn't expect it or hope for it, but it is like what I'm always afraid of is somebody, you know, what psychologists call the imposter syndrome. Like I just know somebody's going to be like, you know, you're Brian Brushwood. You're not an expert hacker. Get out of here.
That was usually me saying that, actually.
Yeah, exactly. But the closest to a negative comment in all of the show from anyone ever was somebody talking about when we were doing the Wi-Fi hacking. Like, we have a shot of me typing stuff on the keyboard while I'm talking, and he was just like, oh, I'm pretending to be a hacker. It's like, no, dude. It's more like it's not possible on television to get a boring ass shot of me standing there just, you know, not typing and talking. It's like you speak in pictures. You have to do certain things.
Yeah. What do you want a picture of Brian like looking at stackoverflow.com and reading a book on Python? Like,
we just cut over to a 30-second shot of like, all right.
Yeah. If you calling Darren Kitchens, like, hey. How do I hack?
Getting tech support.
Yeah.
But man, it's like everybody from, you know, adults and kids all seem to like it, and that really makes me happy.
Yeah, you know, I mean, I'm freelance, so I go from gig to gig, and I've been pretty lucky to work on shows that are, you know, decent shows, and, you know, maybe some of the stuff I worked on in the past didn't set the world on fire, but it's I've been lucky to avoid some more like embarrassing types of shows, and to finally be on something that's really cool like this is very gratifying.
You're welcome.
We're so happy to gratify you, sir.
Yeah, you guys are good at it.
You deserve this.
It's really been a trip to actually, because it's the lead-in. I knew that Brain Games was very popular, but I hadn't actually watched it until this episode. And it's interesting to see, you know, the pacing. Like, man, hacking the system moves really fast.
Yeah.
like people are like, I just wish you would go back. And it's like, I'm like, it's on the internet. Also, you can do this.
It really is. Yeah, it's a breakneck pace, but I mean, that's kind of the identity of the show in a way, right?
Is this the part where you two bone on the table?
Yeah, God, this is when her shirt looks like it's totally about to pop right open.
There's going to be a big black bar across the screen in the middle.
If you're like, Pop, you got the job.
50 Shades of Hacking.
You did get the job, though, didn't you?
Yeah, man. I went at everything. That's the there's one moment like they don't in that segment we did with the lie detector. We got a shot of you getting the keys out of the toilet, but it doesn't show up there because you remember at the end you're like yeah, but where are the keys? They're like, oh yeah, no, they're in the toilet, and you walk off screen.
Yeah.
But the shot of you getting the keys shows up later in what was it, the How Not to Be a Sucker episode? What do we end up calling?
Really?
Yeah. It starts off with a montage of all the shitty moments that we did to you over the course of it.
Really?
Yeah. It's like,
is that one of the ones I haven't seen yet?
I think so. Maybe. it's the Don't Be a Sucker one.
Right.
This guy was very cool, man. Just a random Joe on the street. And it's sort of a complicated strategy to explain to someone. And he picked it up. God, that looks great. Whenever I see a shot like that, I'm just like, Doug Cheney.
Doug Cheney.
It's not as random as you think. You can actually exploit these patterns to win. So did you What's next? Restaurants is next?
Yeah.
Restaurants is next. Was that you as well, Alex? I don't remember.
Yeah.
It was, yeah.
I thought
yeah.
so. Okay.
That was the first one I did. That was the first day of production.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. Do you remember that shoot?
Yeah, I do. I do.
That was that was the first, like, true 14 hours. Like, you wake up at 4 a.m. and just blah, blah.
Oh,
and
you started to get sick. Well, we'll get to
that. Yeah.
Yeah, we'll get to that.
Look at that Doug Cheney shot.
Yeah, we were very lucky to have a good DP on this.
Yeah. Good camera crew all together. Jimmy and Doug and Kevin.
Yeah, all those guys are great.
At Six Flags Magic Mountain.
Dude, this was...
I wasn't in any of these shots.
Oh, you were off riding the rides.
I might have been on a bunch of roller coasters during this.
You totally did. We walked in, you're like, yeah, so you don't need me for a while. Like, yeah. Yep, and then,
I'm looking
boom.
At the script, and I'm like, okay, we've got this and this and this. And we were escorted around by, like, the manager of the park.
It was pretty
And
rad.
The whole crew, and, you know, and we were doing this. And here's me. Swing the mallet just like you're chopping wood. Lead with your dominant hand. Next thing you know, I'm on the Batman ride or whatever the hell it was.
So, man, to get these beautiful slow motion shots, I had to hit that thing a lot. And
your arms
and
were like...
Every single time, I wanted to impress everyone around me. So every single time, I gave it 100%. And then at the end, it was like, it was amazing.
Oh, man, and nothing will put the pressure on you like the High Striker. It really is. I mean, I think you say in the voiceover that it's like one of the ultimate, like, cliches of masculinity. You know?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that if you get, like, below 70, your dick just falls right off.
That's a law.
In front of all of those people.
Here was another thing we did that, you know, it's in theory, it's going to work, but I was actually really nervous about doing this one because it sounded like, even with the hack, it's supposed to be very hard. And then Ryan, you like did it immediately.
Well, and what's funny is there's certain things where it's like, if there's even a little bit of skill involved, I'm like, yeah, I don't know, guys. And then it's like, well, let's try it. Let's just go. And then it's like the cameras are on, the lights are on, everybody stands around, everyone gets silent, and they're like, now just do it. And I'm like, oh, shit. And so here I am trying to be a marksman with a admittedly, you know, this rapid-fire gun is designed to not be accurate.
Pop quiz. Who got shot with the AK-47? Show of hands.
Oh, was it you?
I got shot with it.
I didn't know that.
You got shot with it?
Did Jimmy
multiple times. You guys didn't? God, I think Jimmy shot me. I think Brian shot me. Left in there.
That sounds about right.
Sons of bitches. Of course, Jimmy Faye shot me.
Man, Jimmy Faye is such a character.
Yeah, I wonder what that guy is up to now.
I don't know. We should have him on.
Yeah, you totally should.
Yeah, we should.
Yeah, he's a funny guy.
I asked. Okay, I threw out a. I don't know if it looks like nobody in the chat even caught it, but that guy I specifically. Asked him to call me Pinky because that was the running joke was in the studio. The color correction wouldn't work right, and there's so much red light in here that I always look like bright pink, like sunburned. I guess I am healthy and pink, but I would get like really sensitive about it and get pissed off. I was just like, I'm not pink. I'm not that pink. And so. And so, like, as a nod to, there we go. Okay, Jackie Hearn just got to that part. That's awesome.
does anyone listening in the chat room, you rage?
Hey, look, there's Jason.
Hey, yeah, that's right. I did ride that one. It was great, but it only took like 6 seconds. It was such a
oh, watch this. This is
oh, that place. We had lunch there.
We did.
Oh no! Different bar.
Yeah, but
different
okay.
place altogether.
No, here's all right. When it comes back, I just want you to see this. So for most of this, I'm doing my best to speak like an authority, to land the moves and keep the script going or whatever. But there's a couple of moments. One is during the restaurants episode when we get to the fire eating, and the other is when we do this stuff with the bar bets. Like the moment we get to those, it's like this is turf that I have done. For a dozen years.
It was funny because somebody came up to me, I think it was like Kevin or Jimmy or something, and they were like, man, Brian's really on today. He's really feeling. I'm like, Oh, the bar things? Yeah. He's, well, yeah, he's got this. It's no problem. But so, yeah, chat room. Let's see if you got any questions for us, or specifically Mr. Alex Burns.
Yeah, dude.
Who worked with us. He was in the trenches with us on the Western Front for 10 weeks there.
Was it only 10 weeks?
It was. Yeah, I know, right?
No way.
It was only 10 weeks.
Yeah. In my mind, it's gone from like 3 months to 5 months to half to all of the year.
Yep, no. 10 weeks, man.
Wow.
We're brothers now.
I guess it's true.
If you die, and God forbid, something happens to your wife, Alex actually has to take care of your three children.
It's true, yeah.
Yeah.
I can do. I'm good at that, though. I'll be good for that.
Oh, yeah, clearly. He's got a beard. You can trust him.
Yeah. I don't have any kids, so if I die, you guys just have to be pallbearers.
He's seen kids before.
Hey, do me a favor, guys. I totally forgot. We got started so late. I forgot to remind everyone that the hashtag is hacking the system. Hashtag hacking the system. Hit us up. Tell your friends. Let's blow this stuff up. Finally, that darn Super Bowl got out of the way. And finally, maybe we can make something hit the trending list. And invite everyone else to get over here as well.
Yeah. We trended on the first two episodes.
Gambling right. Man says, hey, remember Sparkle Fandango? Me neither. Has it been a while? Is it on hiatus?
Yeah, they haven't. Sparkle Fandango is something on RageSelect.com where my wife Allison and my dear friends Kristen and Kayla do Let's Plays of video games, and they act a fool. And there hasn't been one in a while because they haven't been able to get it together. But that's not cool, Gambling Man. Keep it to hacking the system questions. We don't need any Loco Steve nonsense or dying of fire.
Wait, what?
I'm trying to keep everything on track. Otherwise, it'll just turn into another goddamn idiotic podcast.
Oh, okay. You're trying to not treat this like Rage Select. I get it.
Exactly.
So, okay, here we go. What was the most difficult segment to shoot from these episodes, and why? I know my answer. What's your answer, Alex? I think yours is actually not in this episode.
Yeah. Well,
actually, one of them is in this episode. Okay, all right.
I think it is. I don't know.
You should probably edit. You know,
that we'll keep to ourselves.
Like, yep. Yep.
But the when we were trying to spear the fish.
Oh, dude,
that was difficult.
That was a challenge.
That was a pain in the ass.
Has that episode aired yet?
No. That's the second to last that we're airing.
When they show, I don't know if you've seen the commercial yet. They throw it on here sometimes, but that awesome sunsetting top of the mountain Lord of the Rings shot of us backpacking across is all across the bottom of it. It looks amazing, dude.
It looks pretty cool.
Yeah, that episode was apparently turned out pretty good.
Dude, I there we go. See, this is the ad right
hot.
Here.
It was really hot.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah.
Way too easy. Hacking the system.
See, right another across the bottom, episode. Little Lord yeah. of the Rings.
On National Geographic.
Oh, yeah.
I'm Samwise, too. Frodo. Master Frodo.
I'm staying at a house that doesn't have cable, so I haven't been able to catch it.
So standing outside of a bar and talking, I can't help but start to do the scam school kind of,
I know. That's what I noticed. That's when I realized. I was like, oh, Brian's fine. I was like, yeah, Brian's got this, because he was...
Like, I'm gonna be.
Yeah.
I go into like a Kmart Jack Black Houdini.
I teach you one. Are you down for that? Oh, and then all right, I remember her, this participant, because I'm pretty sure she flew in directly from Rivendell.
She is, dude. She's like a pixie.
Yeah. Answer for a free drink, she weighed whatever. About 20 so pounds. This
is our explorer. I saw someone ask a question about how you write for a show like this.
Yeah.
And so I guess I would like to take the opportunity to like clear up that it's in no way your traditional writing. It's like mainly a lot of research and then researching the research to find out that it's valid. And then just kind of laying out the facts and then coming up with a plan for what you hope to accomplish. And then... just kind of putting all of the onus on you two guys to actually make it happen.
Well, like, and what's there's this agonizing moment where it's like you find a good idea and you find enough evidence that you're like, oh my God, if we could do this, this would be amazing.
Yeah.
And then you dig just a little bit deeper, a little bit deeper, and then you're like, ah, this got debunked.
Or you get out there and you try it and you're like, this doesn't work at all.
Yeah, that definitely happened with the dry ice thing.
With the original, yeah.
And the dry ice thing is, what's great is that awesome, amazing slow-mo shot of the dry ice. That's what I love about the show is because it works. If we try something and it doesn't work, it's just as valuable information, you know, if it's something, because we debunked in the first thing, the crosswalk stuff, and then also, you know, we experimented with the dry ice to remove the dents and found out that it didn't. This one, okay, all of this stuff, I don't know if you remember, Alex, but...
Why does he look like such a sexy bartender?
Because he's an actually sexy bartender.
Is he going to emasculate me when I try to order a mint julep? I think so. Because I ordered mint julep.
So
but look at him.
This guy is so. So all right. So I read all the steps, and the first thing I did was call a friend of the show, Dennis Rogers, who is a former world champion arm wrestler. And I was like, man, is this all legit? He's like, yeah. He's like, a lot of this stuff is specifically outlawed in tournament play because it works so well. And it's like, no kidding.
Which will turn his it's more for bar bets. Yeah, if you were going to be in an actual tournament, you would be disqualified. But if you're looking to, you know, beat somebody like this, you should, like Brian, you should not be beating.
Look at those veins. Look at those veins coming down. I was so proud.
Look at that. He's about to poop his pants.
Oh, man. Yeah, it's cheating, basically. But it's true. I mean, like, the facts about it are true.
Well, yeah, I mean, and I love it. Like, that shot so clearly shows how much of my entire body that I'm putting behind it to get that down.
Yeah. You also made this guy follow the rules. Like, he was not allowed to cheat.
Yeah.
you hush, Alex. Brian bested him.
Don't take this from me.
Brian bested him.
Hey, can I tell you, like this is one of those, this segment, like you said your dad used to bet on the horses and stuff? Was it your dad or your uncle?
My dad likes the ponies, yeah.
This is like...
Phrasing.
This was like the most transformative segment for me because I really could not make heads or tails out of any of that. And I remember, you know, like we talked to some experts and explained what to look for, and I remember there was a down moment, and I just went through, and I was looking at the races, and there was one of the next like five races, because we wanted to actually place a bet, we wanted to actually not know whether or not I was going to win or not, and I saw of the next five races, the next one like within 15 minutes, 20 minutes, was the only one that had a single horse with a mad standout number from all the others. What's that, the buyer's what number?
I don't know.
Watch the show.
Exactly. It's all been pushed out by now.
The Myers-Briggs number, I think, is what it was.
I don't think it's Myers-Briggs. I was actually home already by this point.
Oh, that's right. Because
this was the last day.
Yeah,
this was the very last day.
Yeah, and you went out to San Francisco to shoot this, and I got to go home and have sex with my wife.
Yes, I was very jealous. I mean, not
we flew up there and back in one day.
So okay, now this is the amazing part, right? So it's like I just told him I was like, look, I went and placed a $100 bet, and it's like this is my own real ass money because I was like I wasn't gonna do some weenie bet. So it's like I went and I whipped out $100. I got the ticket. I was like, guys, it's starting now. It's starting now. And so they whip out the cameras, and you get this amazing moment. I was blown away. It was like magic. It was like actually knowing in advance who was gonna win.
So remember, Twitter, flood them right now. Hashtag hacking the system. Bam 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 bam. Let's do it.
Boop 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 boop.
Maybe I should do that too, huh?
Are you on Twitter?
I'm on Twitter.
Yeah, what's your Twitter?
You don't even follow us.
I follow you guys, don't I?
You do?
You got a billion different Twitter, you know, like.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm almost sure I do. I am at the Alex Burns.
At the Alex Burns. Let me.
And Burns is BYRNES.
Yeah, I remember because Brian couldn't pronounce it for like half the shoot.
Burns? Byerns?
Yeah, it's not that bad.
No.
I've heard it all, though. I'm sure you know how it is. Well, you guys probably don't know how it is. Murphy and Brushwood are very straightforward.
Bushwood. Nobody can write my name. They can say it, but they can't write it.
I just get Murphy.
The Alec Murph Burns. All right, so that was the How to Win at Everything. This is restaurants.
Restaurants. Restaurant Ruses, I think, is the title, right?
Yeah.
Is that what we wound up going with?
I think so.
Dude,
I read that
I'm
in an
so
email.
Sorry, I didn't follow you, Alex. I got to fix this.
Oh, outrageous.
I think I click. Hang on.
So I'm curious, what did you guys do yesterday during the Super Bowl?
I actually did homework because I knew today would be a busy day. Man, so I last night I watched Mad Dogs, the American remake, starring Romany Malco. And
oh yeah, yeah.
And I watched some more Marco Polo for Cord Killers. Mm.
I celebrated, and I have to wish her a happy birthday to my dear wife. Today is her birthday.
Hey! Right, happy birthday!
We celebrated yesterday with some drinks and some karaoke.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Did not watch the sports ball at all.
I didn't think you guys did.
Yeah, no, but you did, right? I'm sure.
I sure did.
It sounded like, judging from Twitter, it was a good one, too.
I remember
it was good. It was
Paul,
fun.
Paul came out. He was like, so you guys Cowboys fans or Texans fans? Asking me and Brian, and I was like, those are sporting guys, right?
They're sportimers.
Yeah. And Paul was just like,
you're like, we got a couple of these on our hands, do we? Yeah.
Do they use D20? Is it like GURPS? What is it? Going to a popular
restaurant. Oh, Brian Brushwood just followed me.
Yeah, now you're somebody.
I'm official.
Oh, God, this was so satisfying. The collection of the way Jason gets treated here makes me very happy.
Yeah, this was the first day. And what, I don't know if you remember, well, I'm sure you do remember this, but there's a whole bit that's not in this episode where you ate a whole lot of noodles.
Oh, dude! Yeah, we were going to do it like
didn't that get axed?
Well, and what's funny is I actually on purpose, I did all the things. I drank all the water. I expanded my stomach. And I was like, I'm gonna nail this. And I fucking ate a shit pot of noodles. And it was like I spent the rest of the day with like looking preggers. And I guess it was all for naught. Also, go ahead.
I was just going to explain, you know, that it was going to be this bit about how to win, like, an eating contest. Not, like, against other people, but in a restaurant where they're like, eat this huge amount of food in an hour, and it's free. And, yeah, you ate a huge, huge amount of food and did all this prep, and we shot too much for the episode, and it didn't make the cut.
Yeah, say, you know what else didn't make the cut was the impromptu fire extinguisher.
Oh, man.
Were you there in the room during that?
I was too tiny, so I was just outside the door.
It's terrifying. It's terrifying. Like the whole like to have what is to create an uncontrolled fire or a seemingly uncontrolled fire. I mean, it was fairly controlled conditions, but we needed a fire to erupt. I needed to casually deliver the script, all factually correct. I needed to combine ingredients. I needed to combine reagents. To cast and then seal the top and then stab it with a knife and then spray out the fire, all while trying to act just like cool as a cucumber, like
and say the lines exactly right.
This happens all the time, you know. Whole giant crazy grease fire bursts out. Here's what you do, bro. And it was the most terrifying part of the whole thing, but it got cut for time. And also because it makes sense, because you know the push for this episode was for take home hacks that. That would be practical and whipping up a MacGyver fire extinguisher is probably not the most common thing on the planet for people to do.
Yeah, this is supposed to be from the diner's perspective, you know, not really somebody working in the kitchen. So yeah.
Right, exactly.
But can't blame us for trying, you know, want to spice it up with a little fire.
Dude, it was definitely spiced up.
Well, I believe we get a little bit of fire in here in a little bit.
Yeah, we do. As a matter of fact, that whole segment from the same day, I think turned out really well. This came out looking really good.
Oh yeah, when we were practicing this, Donnie, our art director, like slashed his hand open.
Oh dude, that's
yeah,
right.
That's right.
Remember?
Yeah, practicing this bit right here, right? And
it does work.
Yeah, I think he slashed up his hand afterwards. Because I think I did it for reals right there. But it'll get you access. And then
And then I think we were trying for a close-up of it out. And so Donnie was trying to recreate it on another bottle so we could just get a close-up shot of it.
Yeah, yeah.
And then he was slammed it too hard, and it just shattered there.
Cut him open. Yeah, it was pretty bad.
That guy did a lot.
Dude, Donnie took a bullet for us, man. That dude's a freaking hero.
I really think that everybody except for like one guy on the crew took some sort of metaphorical bullet
at some point. Yeah, yes. Is the one guy me? like
except
I'm the
two guys. I'm not gonna say the other guy's name, but he was an ongoing source of humor.
This right here was another one. So several of these things I was familiar with in theory. But, you know, in the rush to get ready to shoot, you don't have a lot of time. Hey, I'm wearing the same shirt. You don't have a lot of time to practice some of these. And this was one where it's like, I was never particularly good at using a lighter or anything to open these. And I just followed the instructions and I was like, oh, it does work. That's great. How convenient.
So Mitsula asks, how long till hacking thermite?
I'm thinking
probably never. It's very easy.
Turns out it's dangerous.
It's also very
dangerous. It's a bit of a big thing to do.
Yeah, they don't let us get away with that one.
Are you about to go poop?
Yeah, you do look like you're taking the iPad with you. Oh, okay.
No. I just went to go get a bottle opener because I'm going to drink some wine.
You're not going to use your shoe? I saw that there's a hack for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, right?
I saw it on TV. It was kind of cool.
I don't think my roommates would be too thrilled with that.
Yeah.
Banging on the wall. A little late here on the East Coast.
That's right. Yeah, I guess it is. It's
Yeah,
it's miserable. I don't know what people are doing living here. all the snow. And I'm from here. I'm from New Jersey. But like, oh my God, the weather. I have become soft. 12 years in Los Angeles, man. And it's like, it's snowing, and I'm like, it's just making me angry.
That'll do it.
No, thank you.
That moment. It was like, everything good here? Like, yeah, I'd like it. He was like, that's great. And then he just marches off with it.
Yeah. They don't treat me like this at the Bell. It was absolutely
fantastic. The Bell? What's the Bell?
Taco Bell. They know me there. They're like, Mr. Murphy, your seat?
That's funny, man. I figured it was like some fancy and I didn't know.
No.
Look at that side boob on Victoria.
Side boob.
Victoria?
Yeah.
Totally made her on Instagram.
Yeah. It turns out her name's Becky. But she told everyone it's Victoria.
Hey, more power to her, you know?
There was... So it's not to embarrass him, there was someone on her crew who fancied
Victoria.
Oh, man.
Yeah. There was one that fancied her more than everyone else.
True. She had her fans, though. Let's not lie. Standing in line worse
than when people cut in front of us. Okay, so this was shot at
Pink's. Yeah.
Oh no, Pink's. Okay, I'm sorry. We were showing the airport thing, and I was thinking.
Yeah. Well, that line. No, that line was. It was Ontario Airport was the one we were at.
Oh, right. Pink's, which is really. I mean, if you're an atheist and you've eaten at Pink's. You're not an atheist anymore. You're an atheist. You eat at Pink's and you're like, oh, there is a God, and he put this delicious hot dog in my mouth. And boy, did we eat a lot of hot dogs.
It was cool. I was excited to be there. You know, I mean, it's a landmark.
Dude, well, and to have the owners, you know, show up and be really nice. Boy, this was so hard to do, to just march up to the front of the line. Like, you know.
This guy was great.
And did... Yeah, I guess they trimmed it for time, but he called me Hollywood. He's like, "Hey, yeah. Hollywood," and I was like, "Wait, what?" It was amazing.
See, I love this. Jupiter Ascending. This is what paid us right here. The Wachowski brothers. Yeah.
Dude, I forget to watch. I forget to pay attention to the ads. It's funny because I know that we skew, from what I've seen of the numbers, we skew very male, which. Not a surprise.
Like stupidly male. Like, wow. This is a locker room.
This it's gym sore. You could smell our gym socks. My daughter.
I feel like
this is not the first time Jason said I hate you to Brian. No.
No.
Very much not.
Robert underscore says he's been to Southern California. Let me
do this for you, Jason. Is that one easier for you to read?
Oh yeah, that's good. Yeah, cool. Thank you.
Go. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then there's it's over there too.
Oh good.
So yeah.
Good. Yeah. I was looking over there because last time you had it over here. Yeah. You gotta see Brian's studio. It's ridiculous.
Save thousands on your next purchase.
That was way too easy.
Hacking the System. New episodes Mondays at 10.
I don't know why, but it's like I'm watching the show and I'm like, yeah. I know all this. I was there.
We're always, Alex. You'll get a kick out. We're always more excited when we see the commercial than we are when the actual episode's on.
I was just picking that up. Well, you know, because the commercials are new to us, you know, like we know what the episodes are going to be, but we just wait to see what the network's going to do.
It's funny, the same thing, like on premiere night, they had a little low, in the lower third, they had superimposed, it says hashtag hacking the system, and I was like, I suggested that hashtag, and it's like, yeah, no shit, asshole, you were also the star of the show. I'm like, oh, yeah.
Also, what else were you going to put as the hashtag?
Well, I don't know.
Hashtag like, touched by an angel.
Or, you know, like Nat Geo hack, or, you know, because you want it to be short, and that's a fairly long hashtag.
Hashtag Phineas and Ferb. No, of course it's hashtag hacking the system.
So we got, who are our sponsors? Jupiter Sending, Priceline.
And then I think this is probably a pill.
I bet Jupiter Sending is
gonna... Wealth Management. It's money.
Oh.
I thought it was going to be, I thought he was going to be talking about her hygiene. Are you asking hygiene.
Questions about the way your wealth
is managed? He asked her, you ever feel not so fresh?
Yeah. Or maybe she asked him that.
Are you guys in for Jupiter Ascending?
I'm curious. Yeah, you know.
I'm in.
This is what Wachowski joint, right?
Yeah. I'm not like sold, but they have yet. Okay, let me retract that. I'm not going to say they've yet to make a bad movie. But Cloud Atlas was cool.
I liked that movie a lot.
You know? Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you see it?
No, I wanted to read the book before I saw it.
Like, oh, okay.
Like, it was one of those where it's like, I wanted to give it my full attention and have the full experience. And then, you know.
But nobody's making movies like that.
Yeah.
You know? Great. You just don't see that anymore. You see Guardians of the Galaxy, which was this insane fluke.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And was phenomenal. So yeah, it's like, wow, big, epic, operatic space film. Sure. Yes, absolutely.
Have you guys seen Jodorowsky's Dune?
Oh, I really
no,
want
I
to.
Want to. I read all about it though. Yeah. And
you guys are going to love it.
I heard the documentary was fantastic.
Yeah, it's really good. I watched it just the other day.
Dude,
makes you really wish that movie was made.
There was a little bit of it talked about in Chris Taylor's book, How Star Wars Conquered the Universe, which is phenomenal. It tells that whole story of all the amazing talents and movies that it begat.
Yeah, they kind of get that at the end of the movie, and it's solid.
So if you guys are anywhere in the Los Angeles area, go to Pink's, for God's sakes, and eat a hot dog, because they're just so delicious.
It's worth the line experience, too.
Yeah.
Even though I'm cheating.
And they're... How many?
So what I like about this, I don't know. I think we're at the middle segment here. They actually have. Maybe by starting in the middle, people won't. Yeah. Okay. All right. I'm gonna save my story till the end. But like, different aspects of this line test that we did, I watched happen in real life, and I have real life stories of when I watched it be successful, and when I didn't. This here. Mind if I jump
in with you? No. There's a line back there. All right. Move around. Can you not see it?
Right. So that didn't work.
So now I'm gonna do literally one person in front of this guy and ask Jason. Let's see if that works.
Buddy, you mind if I join you?
Oh, yeah. Sure.
I wish I'd just gone. Fuck you!
Just turn off.
You could have.
Turn around and deck me.
Probably wouldn't have made the cut.
I'll show you how in a sec. But first, check this out. Almost 1.3.
Man, I love these. Have you ever played the game Wits and Wagers, Alex?
How much of this do you think of?
What's it called? I don't think so.
Wits and Wagers. It's essentially this. It's essentially everybody guesses. You take an aspect that, you know, a question that could be, you know, you wouldn't be surprised if it was any of those answers, and you just have people guess. It's like these little stinger moments where you get to play Wits and Wagers going into commercial breaks.
Is it like a card game, or is it just like
notepad game, like a card's drawn and it's a question like that. Everyone makes their bet and then you their guess, and then you pick you get more points if people think yours is the right one, and mix it kind of like Balderdash. You know, mixed in there is the right answer. So you get points if people think it's yours, but you also get points. You can change your mind and pick, you know, one of the other ones.
You know what I'm finding during watching all of this right now? I'm finding that the first thought that comes to mind during each of these scenes is, yeah, that was really hot.
Oh, my God. All I'm going to remember is sweating.
Yeah. Some of them more than others. Some of the scenes were sweatier than others. Usually the warehouse scenes were actually sweatier than, say, standing in line at Pink's.
Yeah.
This was great. We shot this
like four times.
Maybe four times.
We ate like four hot dogs a piece. It was awesome.
It was so great.
Like, all right, we're like, oh, is this an idea again?
Yeah.
Like, we can do it again. So that whole starting at the back and asking each individual person to go forward, I experienced in real life in a passport office. There was a long ass line. I was about midway through, and some poor guy was having like a real emergency, and everyone in the room saw him say, "Yeah, but I need to see my wife and the flights and blah 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 blah." This guy was like a Latin immigrant or whatever, and they're like, "You have to go to the back of the line because they're in line here." So he went back and he went to every single person in line. He was like, "Excuse me, would you mind if I went ahead of you?" And every single person did it, and they went up and they gave him crap at the front of the office. They're like, "I told you there was a line," and it's like you could ask each of them, and he's like, "I did," and he's like, "No, you did," and then the whole line is like, "He did. Take care of him." It was like this amazing mob moment. Yeah.
Nice.
I like that. You can count on people, real, you know, not all of them, but mainly people are good, right?
Yeah.
This is one of the most applicable things that I think we did, was all of these psychological restaurant tricks that you're bombarded with every time you go eat. You know?
There's also, if you like this stuff, there's a great Freakonomics episode about Freakonomics Radio about the psychology and the culture and the economics of tipping. And they point out a lot of these little things like, females do better than males, blondes do better than brunettes, skinny people do better than heavier people, blah, 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 blah. And the service is, like, the only thing that matters in these restaurants. Like, the food practically doesn't even matter at all.
Speaking of which, I may have some. You know, you can eat anywhere, but you want somebody to, like, cater to you. Make you feel special. You get a lemon in your
drink? It depends on the drink.
That's the most I've ever juggled in my life.
Oh, that's right.
I was so very proud. Bacteria.
Okay, that's disgusting. Why? What are you talking about?
It makes sense. Think about it.
The I remember it was like, oh yeah, I can't juggle. Let me go ahead and try to learn this right now.
Well, it's like I knew the principles, but I knew that every time I tried, I was never able to do more than three throws. And then it's like something about that moment, I just started going. It was like the longest I'd ever gone.
So my beer of choice is Hefeweizen.
Oh, shoot.
And as you know, Hefeweizen usually comes with a wedge of lemon or, alternatively, a wedge of orange.
Right.
I'm usually like, no. No, just the beer.
Yeah, because man, that whole thing. Have 100 times more bacteria than the toilet seats in the exact same restaurant. There you go. That's one of those Alex Burns facts. Highlight that. Put an AB on it.
Hey guys, you get a chance to look. That's the fun part of the job, man.
Awesome. Well, and that's the funny part because there's like a negotiation. It's like we want to convey an accurate fact in a punchy way. Like that's a good stat, right? 100 times more bacteria than the toilet seat. But we also need to make sure that we do it in a way that the Nat Geo can back as well. And so there's this. I don't know. Like I feel really good about all of the facts that we put out there. This
menu has no. Yeah, they don't screw around at NetGeo.
We got a question.
Yeah, a bunch of people noticed the Diamond Club on the laptop. I forgot. I forgot that I covered it in Diamond Club stickers. Let's see. You could tell if that's happening by looking for. Schwed wants to know if there's a ruby red Hefeweizen, and I don't think there is. That's the St. Charles, by the way, saying that.
Oh, Charles St. Charles, which is proof that Charles St. Charles is not me. It's somebody else.
Is that proof?
It's proof. I'm right here. We're kind of sort of in the same room together. Like Batman and Bruce Wayne next to each other.
Let's see. Robert underscore says, Brian will awkwardly touch you. Be prepared. Brian crouching like some servant gopher man, which is my natural state. Oh, dude, this one killed me. What ingredient is almost in almost every meal you eat? Salt, skin, saliva, or all of the above? Job interview. Hey, look, there's that commercial I like.
All right, so what was your number one, YouTube? What was your number one favorite hack for, like, the whole 10 episodes that we shot?
Oh, I know what mine was.
Oh, really? What is it?
The four-leaf clover one, man. I loved that one.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Dude!
Alex?
I agree. I thought that one was really good.
You guys, Jesus.
The holiday episode really turned out is so much fun. I dig it because it's a light departure. I love the fact that we can have a show that scares the crap out of everyone, like the personal security episode.
Yeah.
And that we could also have one with so many takeaways that I think the holiday episode is going
to
go around.
I love what happened on our way to film the holiday episode. And,
oh, geez.
Hey, now let's party.
We'll talk about that when it airs. When it comes.
Yeah.
Save that one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Allie Murphy in the chat says, my favorite hack is when Jason flew home after being gone for 10 weeks.
Oh, I think I hooked up with that chick one time.
Let's see. Sharpie says, the show is kind of like The Real Hustle in the UK. I would say that Scam School is more like The Real Hustle in form because they deal with bar bets and scams. Whereas what I like about hacking the system is that it's so open-ended that it could go so many different places.
I'll be interested to see, hopefully, fingers crossed, season 2.
Oh my God, yeah.
I'd like to know what we would come up with.
Hashtag hacking the system on Twitter.
Yeah, hashtag hacking the system. What do you got to say, beautiful people?
You know, I had an idea for season 2.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. I want you to figure out how to hypnotize me into eating better and doing like a little bit of exercise, and then we can track my progress for the entire season. And then put it like in the last episode.
I'll tell you what's funny is that would actually definitely work because you would have unbelievable social pressure on you to follow through on your commitment.
Well, I mean, I don't know. Food for thought.
Oh my God, Theater Monkey. Yeah, thank you for fixing that flat tire. Theater Monkey was there in Los Angeles when I rode my bike out. And unfortunately, Theater Monkey, I don't know if I told you, after you fixed the flat on my bike, there was apparently something in there that was poking holes, and so the second one it got flat again on the way back.
Theater Monkey helped you out, and then I came to pick you up?
Yes, that's... yeah, it was amazing.
Yeah, it sucked. I was like, I'm halfway home. Brian's like, hey, I'm still up in North Hollywood. I got a flat.
Oh, wait. No. That was the chain thing. That's where the chain broke.
Okay.
No. This was when I had you walk up to ride my bike back from the bike shop when I had the tire fixed. It was with like a mile north of our place in Marina Del Rey.
Right. Okay.
I'll tell you what, man. I like that space, but I know that there was a lot of driving that we had to do. That was a lot of driving.
Oh my God, we were on the road so much.
But then we listened to The Martian.
Yes.
We got
fantastic.
Most of the way through, or we got part of the way through. Name of the Wind.
Halfway through Name of the Wind.
Did you finish it yet?
I did.
And did you go on to the next one?
No.
Not yet.
No, I'm never going to do that.
Wait, really?
No, I might actually. No, I might actually read the sequel. I just wasn't totally compelled like I was during The Martian. Spent a lot of time on the 45. You're not Mr. A lot. Because we were staying
the
in Marina
405. The 405. 405. Yeah.
45's here. The 405. Yeah. We drove a lot. Like, remember that day when we were at, what, Bob Hope?
No.
Ontario.
Yeah.
Ontario. And then we drove all the way up to Six Flags during rush hour.
Oh, wait. No. Yeah. No, it must have been. It was Bob Hope. Yeah. Because we were at Bandwagon Media for their live streams.
Yeah. That sucked.
Yeah, that was a thing.
Yeah, it's like, okay, well, we're going to shoot this segment.
Do you have to, hey, Alex, do you get to go to the same place every day?
I More or less, yeah.
Right. What's that like?
Well, it's, you know, we some weeks we shoot, some weeks we don't. So right now, the office is up in Manhattan, but when we're filming, it's down in Trenton. So I'm staying in Trenton for like 4 days straight. So it's okay to go to the same place every day, and it's good for work. But, you know, I mean, and no offense to Trenton, but like, you can't exactly walk down the street to get a beer.
That was the crazy part. Was we were always shooting in different places. It was all over the place.
Yeah, it was. We were all over the place. It was fun though, right?
Man.
Yes.
Okay. So this part.
Yes,
okay,
is the answer to that question.
This guy doesn't want to. All right, so at this point we do the special dessert presentation, and I remember out of everything that happens during the special presentation at the end, I remember being far and away the most terrified about actually cooking bananas flambé. like that was like, I needed to actually cook and make it edible and have it be good, and I'm like, I don't know how to cook, I can't cook. And it was like, you just combine this, you do this, you saute that. No, I'm like I don't think you understand. If it doesn't go in a microwave, I don't eat it. I don't know if I can.
what did we eat all summer?
Oh, dude, those Dinty Moore little heat meats.
Totino's party pizzas.
Yeah, yes, that's my speed.
Microwavable burritos. And, of course, breakfast at McDonald's.
Yeah, oh, dude, every time.
Every day.
Time. I'm still paying for it. I'm still working off that debt.
Still have that trainer?
Yeah, I do. So this is one of those moments where after this long day and all this crazy stuff, and after putting out fires, literal fires, like, we get to this part where I'm doing my fire eating stuff, and this is like so comfortable for me. This is the most natural and comfortable I felt all day, was doing this stuff.
During this part, I was actually upstairs in this little, I think where all like the extra gear was stored, and like excess food and stuff for the restaurant.
Yeah.
And I was writing these blog posts for the Nat Geo website. I was writing a blog post for every episode.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But I can
still blow it. None of them got used.
Wait, no, they didn't.
No.
Oh no. Hey, look at that. Look at that smiley face. Which has been proven
to have a positive effect on. There you go. And I'm
delighted. Time and glow.
Let's see if they caught it. About $150.
I pulled in nearly 200 by just using a few tricks. I also took a huge dump in that one guy's salad.
Okay, all right.
He didn't even notice. The more people spend on their meal, the greater satisfaction they report.
So it's like a win-win-win. The restaurant makes more, the waiters make more, the customer goes. It's true. I just saw another study the other day that was just talking about wine, how people will enjoy more expensive wines even if it's the same bottle. They will love it more because they spent more money on it.
What? Really? Yeah. So we know we love it's. I guess that's also the same thing with, like, you know, I hired a trainer, or I joined a group where I pay extra at the gym just for that accountability to get, you know, because I have to go because I spent money. It's like, what, am I not going to go?
I bet you pay more for the gym than I do.
I bet so. So much so we spend over $32
billion every year on it, making it our number one. I had pizza for dinner tonight.
Oh, that's right. Oh, my gosh. We're at the end.
Hey. Oh, yeah, because I was pointing that at everyone's crotch.
Oh, dude. And Jimmy Faye got a hold of it and just and for the rest of the shoot was constantly testing the temperature of everything.
Yeah.
You got a thingy plug?
Oh, yeah.
I hear that I could use a piece of paper, though.
There you go. Of course, it depends on where you are and where you go. But Jason and I are conducting
a highly unscientific test. That's the other thing, too, is like moments like that, it's weird stuff that you don't think of. It's like, you know, oh, I'm going to go to Hollywood and we're gonna shoot this thing. But it's like, man, there's a lot of driving and talking at once. And you know, I have to drive safely and also be good at talking.
I was lying down in the back seat.
Yeah, that's right.
It's like a round in the back.
Yeah, and it's like I would flub a line, and then or it's like I'd say it, and then there'd be a correction. I'm like,
every time I see a Chevy Impala, I'm just like, I lived in one of those this summer, man.
Yeah.
Because by the end of it, it was just full of clothes and McDonald's wrappers.
Well, yeah, that was our wardrobe was back in the back. Yeah. 17 minutes later.
101.4. Nice. Just above room temperature.
Yeah.
And what did we learn?
Hey, man.
It may be a little bit colder, and I had to wait a little longer, but I didn't have to leave the house.
Touché, sir. The point of pizza is to stay on the couch.
What's funny is Bonnie has specifically forbidden me from ever eating on camera for anything ever.
No eating, no dancing.
Yeah, I'm not allowed to eat, and I'm not allowed to dance. And it's like, and this show has so much of me eating on camera. Especially, like, I told her about the noodle eating thing, and she was just like, Brian. Dude!
Yeah, that episode in particular.
Yeah, no, certainly the restaurant one. Dude, that is T2. Thank you, Estonia. We're in the civilized Fahrenheit. not your skullduggerous Celsius, sir. Mitzula says, Nat Geo double checks everything, lets you claim that 101 degrees is room temperature. In that warehouse, I can say it almost certainly was plus or minus 5 degrees of room temperature.
God, the warehouse.
Yeah, it was hot in there.
And they were shooting The New Girl next door.
Oh, really?
Yeah. For a couple of days anyway.
I like.
And then they shot, NCIS there?
Yeah,
like,
yep,
actually,
they did.
In our warehouse?
When
we weren't there?
Yeah. No, I like that warehouse was a cool space. It was funny how quickly you start to feel ownership of little spaces like that, you know?
Absolutely.
Dude, I guess that's it. We'll take, I'll tell you what, we'll open up lines. You guys could call in to Night Attack Show if you have any questions about what it's like to write for a show like Hacking the System. But regardless, thanks for everyone showing up and watching and definitely, God damn it. Somebody's just tweeting, pizza! Somebody give me a link to pizza. I don't think Alex has ever seen that. So much good. Casey Friel says on Twitter, good to know Schwood has a future in food service if the TV magic thing doesn't work out. Hacking the System. Dear Hacking the System, many things you did in your rest episode are right on. But I train servers that kneeling down at tables is unprofessional. That may be, well, but it gets tips.
You're wrong.
Should I respond to him?
Yeah, do it.
That may be, but it's apparently effective at generating more tips.
My friend Kristen at Sparkle Kristen says, I like Captain Murphy just fucking around with a heat meter by himself. Amusing. Yeah.
Learning to eat fire can increase your tips by 30%. Hashtag hacking the system.
Also increase your chances for cancer.
Okay, so yeah, here, take a look. This is the pizza clip. I don't know if you, here we go.
Another game with the help of marketing experts.
Oh wait, no, not that one. I want the original one.
For our next experiment, we're setting up a taste test. We'll be rigging our food stand.
Here, I'm
going to
kill this right there. Boom. Gone. I want the original. I was going to share the original pizza clip with him. That's fine. Oh, wait. It occurs to me now. Wait. I just realized now I could show all of this.
What?
No. We were trying to. There we go. Here. You could look on this one. Here, look at that. I don't know if you'll remember this commercial.
Pizza!
What the hell's happening?
When pizza's on a bagel, you can eat pizza!
All right.
And any other time, try
I don't know why that tickles me so.
Now you have to show the Full House pizza. That earworm.
Hold on. I actually don't know that, but I do know something that I absolutely must show. Alex, twitter.com/Schwood. The fans have taken to making their own ads for Hacking the System.
Wow.
Yeah, for example, this gem. Let's do
Oh,
this.
Yeah, let's look at my ass again. Great.
No. All right, here we go. here we go. Ready?
Hey,
damn, it feels good to be a gangster.
And that's the one that gets the most traffic. My ass. No, pull up a Full House Pizza. Yeah, there it is.
P-I-C-C-A. Give me pizza.
God damn.
Did I happen to say I want pizza?
Alex is terrified.
P-I-C-C-A. I want pizza.
Hey, are you ready to play?
Now set down the pizza and bring some chicken. Throw it on top and make your finger lick it. Guacamole meatball with cream pouring like waterfalls. Here's a little sauce to make it hot. Here's a lot of ice cream to hit the spot. Toss the fish, let it fly, fly, fly. Pizza pie, pizza. P-I-C-C-A, give me pizza.
I don't know how much more I can take.
Oh, no.
I think Alex might be having some nightmares tonight.
Give me pizza.
I guess that it slowed down.
Do we have the original one? I guess this is it. This is the original one.
That's right. When super, we've cleaned out the refrigerator. Time to make our pizza. As big as some countries. How much pizza do you think we can chow? More than our parents would ever allow. We're gonna make a master pizza. Pizza. A work of art like the Mona Lisa. It's gonna be high like the Tower of Pisa.
Little
kids
rapping
pizza,
about pizza.
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 Did I
happen
to say? I want pizza.
Pizza. Oh, wait, I already lost it. Whatever. Holy crap. That's amazing. All right. Well, look, I think we're going to shut down the stream because we've been going all day long. It's been a crazy hell of a day. Congratulations, Mr. Murphy. Congratulations, Mr. Burns.
Cheers, fellas.
Dude, I can't thank you enough. Alex's birthday was just the other day, and I wrote a
happy birthday.
I wrote him confessional text in which I admitted that out of all the things that came out of hacking the system, getting to be friends with him was probably one of my favorites. Thank you for everything of yourself that you put into these episodes. Cause I say it all the time. It's like, man, I'm just a guy who shows up and tries it. And when it looks awesome, you know, I get all the BS credit, but it's you guys that did the research to find out what's possible, man.
It was a fun show. I mean, that's what, you know, I got to admit it. I enjoyed most becoming friends with you guys making the show as well, and it was a great experience. And you guys were so easy to work with and for. Like it could be so much worse. You know, you guys are a dream to work for.
I mean, I guess so. It's like we hear that was the amazing part is there were so many seasoned veterans who worked on this show and so many others that it was just astonishing. That we avoided so many pitfalls. I mean, everybody had shocking stories of behind the scenes meltdowns and of difficulties and stuff. And it was I'm so glad that we avoided so many of those pitfalls.
We heard a few nightmare scenarios.
We had some close calls. But you know, again, it was amazing.
Oh, no, we'll talk about that later.
All right. Yeah. We'll talk about it later. All right. Well, here, a little blast from the past, to take us out.
P-I-Z-Z-A.
Have you seen this, Alex?
No.
Okay. All right.
Shit is this?
Alex played later. It's amazing.
I don't think Alex is ready for the full night attack experience.
Wow.
So we got the real story behind this. Somebody found this clip and we put it out on the precursor to Night Attack called NSFW, and it blew up. Like within 24 hours, it was on Carson Daly's blog. It was on like, and everything exploded. And it turns out that that this girl, her name's Melissa, was doing a favor for a friend. Her friend at college needed just someone to. They're like, just do it. I got to edit this thing together. I have to make a music video or whatever. Melissa was told that she didn't have to be good at singing because they were gonna dub in the Lady Gaga.
Right.
And she didn't. And it hits this perfect uncanny valley of awkwardness where it's just like just when you think it's done being awkward in one way, it gets awkward in another way. And it just blew up. And unfortunately, the chick who uploaded it was out of the country at the time. So Melissa, out of nowhere, gets exposed to millions of people commenting. And you know how YouTube comments can be, the hateful shit they can post, right?
They can be a little unfair.
Oh, Jesus. That's putting it charitably. And so she was out of nowhere, this 20-year-old girl, just you know, gets attacked with just the most hateful bile of the internet. In the comments, and she can't stop it. They're calling YouTube, and they're like, that's not your video. They're like, yeah, but that's me in the video, and she's gone. We can't get the login. We can't shut this shit down. And she reached out to us directly, and she's like, look, here's what you started. And we're like, oh, we're so sorry.
The last they heard from her, she set herself on fire in an Arby's parking lot.
So we actually... She was so amazingly cool. We had her on NSFW, and we're like, look, we loved your video for all of these reasons. And we were honest. We're like, it's this perfect amount of awkward and, you know, odd and offbeat. But we feel terrible that we exposed you to the hateful elements of the internet. So for the next hour, we're going to bring you a bunch of stories, and whatever it is you say will become gospel. So it's like we found some article that we read, like, from The Guardian, and then we're like, what do you think of that article? And she's like, I don't know. I just feel like people should, you know, get along. And they're like, you heard it, people. And so thousands of people went to the comments section of The Guardian, and they're like, hey, man, I just think everyone should, get along. And so... And then we collected some cash to get her a new iPod because at the beginning she had a very outdated iPod there at the beginning. But that was horrific, man. Man, what a blast from the past.
Poor Melissa.
But she had a really good attitude about it. We're actually friends on Facebook now.
It's a strange world.
It's but there was this brief moment where it was weird because all Justin and I did was dance at the top of the mountain, like, ha la la, look at us. And then we looked down and we're like, that's an avalanche. I think we caused a
There are others that I could have sworn that an avalanche would have happened.
And then didn't. Like what? Or do I not want to know?
You know, I really expected there to be some sort of shitstorm involved with... why did I make you cry? I don't know me anymore.
Oh, dude, we had him on the show.
I know.
Yeah, dude, that was amazing.
Play that shit.
Oh, dude.
Play it.
Yeah, somebody give me Tom.
It's got three T's in it.
Yeah. All right, here we go.
There it is. Ladies, put on your extra absorbent panties because things are about to get wet. Alex, this is for you, my friend.
Oh, man. Chitty. Walking beside you makes me so proud. I just got hard to say that I
love you. Yeah, and they had him on the show, Brian. or Alex.
What did this guy have to say for himself?
What's that?
What did he have to say?
Oh, no, dude. He gave us a live show. It was fucking electric. It was amazing. like he came on, and we were like, because we never know, you know? It's like our, you know, we love finding just the weirdest shit on. We finally came up with the tagline, we're everything right that's everything wrong with the internet, you know? It's like we love all this awkward, weird shit. And then the guy was like, all he knew is that his shit was blowing up with comments, and it came from the NSFW show. And so it's like, well, come on. And he's like, and he was like, and it, you know, we, Yeah, do a concert. Are you kidding me? It was amazing. Also, he definitely looks exactly like I will in 10 years. That's me in 10 years. Look at that face.
Well, Robert says he's your dad. So.
Yeah. I just hope I have those guns by then.
If you have that mullet, I will put a bullet in your head.
Dude, don't think I'm not working on it. Dude, look at this. You see this?
I'm looking. You're good right now.
Look at that.
I'm growing a mullet.
If I have to show up like I'm the goddamn equalizer.
I'm growing a non-ironic mullet. I'm gonna
Are you really?
It's so old. It's new. Yeah.
Don't do it.
Why not?
Don't do it.
Why not?
You have kids to think.
Coming back.
Why not? It's got to be coming back. It's so out. It's got to be in.
Isn't there something in the contract with Nat Geo where you can't do that?
Wait, I mean, dude.
It's like a no mullet clause.
Have you seen Guy on a Buffalo, Alex?
I have seen Guy on a Buffalo.
Right, I went and saw them the other night.
Oh, shit. Where were they playing?
They were playing at Bangers down on Rainy Street.
God damn.
And they were great. There was nobody there. And everybody missed out. I went and, yeah, it was a phenomenal
show. Dude, next time you go, please let me know. I'll get a babysitter. Okay. Bonnie and I, that's all we want to do is have a night and go watch and just go sit and watch. Not doing a gig. Not doing a thing.
Yeah.
Just go and watch the Possum Posse. They're amazing.
They were so much fun. This was 2 or 3 weeks ago.
Yeah. All right. Okay, look, for reals this time. I'm going to shut down. Look, you can tell I'm serious because... Because I'm playing, what am I?
you can play another Tomcat.
Didn't work
song.
Out so much. Yeah. There we go. All right, there. You can tell because I'm playing this. That's how you know. Here, and I'm gonna do this, and then I'm gonna hang up on this one. Stick around till after the stream. Alex.
Yes. Nice.
Thanks, guys. Good night, you kings of chat realm.